set to kick off here, and it's not a home game for either of these teams. And now we bring you the coin toss. It's presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. The pregame festivities are over, and we're just about set to get this game underway. He's to the 20. It's on the ground. It's recovered. So the Badgers having a wide receiver like this, I think sometimes it even helps a young quarterback, because this kid goes out there, he works hard in practice every day, and I think he really lifts the whole offense.
I think he does. I think he's almost like having an extension from the coaching staff into the locker room with the players. He's a guy that makes big plays, but I think he takes it upon himself to be able to help out with some of the other receivers, make sure that they're all on the same page, understand the route adjustments, understand everything that goes on with being a wide receiver and the importance of blocking. So all the little things that seem to add up and make big plays, I think this guy totally understands his responsibility as being a go-to player.
So the booth and the referee agree. The runner's knee was down.
That was still a close call, though, Brad. Even though he was down, this guy has to do a better job of holding that football.
That's a nice 6-yard gain.
Well, he really didn't have to do too much there to give himself a little room to make the catch.
And he's tackled at about the 35. So they'll pick up a first down there on a 4-yard completion.
I think they were expecting a run on that play, Brad, and it allowed the quarterback to throw for just enough yards to get the first down.
It was a great read by the quarterback there to take the snap and throw it quickly to get the first.
The offensive line needs to do a better job of not only handling the defensive linemen, but getting up to the linebackers. That way the ball carriers will have a little bit more room to get to that second level.
So it's 2nd and 14. Ball on their own 31. Screen pass. He's got his halfback. Brought down at about the 45.
That's just a well-executed screen pass. They had the blockers in front, and they got it to him with room to run.
Catches it, and he's immediately tackled behind the line. Second and 12 coming up here. Ball on the 43-yard line. They spread the field in the gun with 5 wide receivers. On the throw, incomplete pass. Boy, would he like to have that one back.
Yeah, you're right. This offense relies so much on timing. And as you saw there, when their timing gets knocked off, they have a tough time connecting on plays like this.
Makes the grab past the marker. And he's level at the 38-yard line.
When you can move the ball downfield in big chunks like that, you've got the defense right where you want it.
Right around the 30. They show pass and then hand it to the back for a pickup of 8 yards.
That makes it 2nd and 2.
And they make the stop around the 26-yard line. And this is not good news. This is a very serious injury. From the 26-yard line, first down. This is going to be a first down. Nice play to set up first and goal.
This guy has that innate ability to get just enough distance from a defender to make a completion possible. You don't see it from every receiver, but this guy's got it.
And he's taken down around the 6-yard line.
Gain of 3 yards. That brings him 2nd and goal.
Sweet block!
and they'll get him in the backfield. The defense has really held their own the last two plays. Now it's third and goal from the 7. That's a backward pass, and the ball bounces out of bounds. The kick is up, and he got it. The Falcons had one of their key players go down earlier, but it looks like he might be able to get back in the lineup. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He'll take it from the 2. He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line. Wisconsin's offense, a lot of times they can spread things out and they can really be versatile offensively, but when you got a wide receiver like this, it really helps the Cubs.
It does, and it continues to help with what they're trying to do. They're trying to find matchups, and when you have one player like this that the defense has got to be aware of, they're going to spread you out, try to find the one-on-one matchup, and if you spend too much time with this one player, they've got some other weapons to make you pay for it.
Their own 30-yard line. It's second down. The Falcons saw one of their top players going down earlier, but it looks like he's going to be able to get back in there. Tackle made around the 32-yard line. He's on the run. He's tackled right around the 46-yard line. From their own 46-yard line, first down. Brought down after a nice run up the middle. Complete, and he's hit right away. And here's another third down. Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
You know, Brad, that's the second third down that they've been able to convert on this drive. And this offense right now has really showed a lot of poise and been able to hold on to the football and try to maintain this drive.
At the corner. He's knocked out of bounds at the 30-yard line. And this is the 8th play of the drive. He's at the 20, and down he goes, right around the 16-yard line. From the 16-yard line, it's first down. Pressured and brought down. Oh, we had a pitcher's duel in that low-scoring first quarter. Bowling Green's got a 3-point lead. And we welcome you back to the action here, and we have got a tight one going on in quarter number 2.
Mike 7. Go 4. Green 9. Go.
He scrambled, runs with it, and he's got room. Big play, and it's first and goal. First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. Touchdown, Badgers. He makes the PAT. It was an 11-play, 73-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
Boy, this offense right now is just being physical, really controlling the line of scrimmage, and it's opening up some nice big lanes for the running backs.
And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. Quick throw. And they push him out at the 37-yard line. They'll bring him down around the 36-yard line. Nowhere to go for the halfback. That's a loss of one.
When you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
It's third down and 11 to go. Ball on the 36. He's got it with room to run. He's taken down at the 43-yard line. Gets out to about the 42-yard line. That's good for a gain of 1 yard. That brings up second and 9. Makes the catch, and the defense is all over him. They bring him down for a loss. Convert here on another third down. The quarterback in the gun, empty backfield, five wide receivers in the formation. Throws it out and it falls incomplete. And they could really put their opponent in bad field position with a good punt here. Gets it away. Wait a minute, he's going to throw. Defense stiffens there and gives it back to their offense. With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. Wisconsin holds a 4-point lead. And he's tackled after positive yardage. Need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. He's run and he's brought down. Carries the ball for a nice game.
That brings him second and five.
Second and five coming up here. Ball on the 39. Now he tries to buy some time. He's at the 30, and he's tackled around the 20-yard line.
Run.
And that one's incomplete. He let that pass get away from him.
I think he's a little bit anxious. He actually looked a little bit too juiced that time. But he'll get the next one.
From the 20-yard line, it's second down. Passes it to the middle of the field. What a play to set him up with a first and goal. Wisconsin is up four. Gets to about the 8-yard line. Pickup of a yard for the tailback. This is the eighth play of this drive. Wisconsin's going to use their first time out of the half here. They'll be looking for the end zone here. Third and goal from the 9. Delivers to the halfback on the screen. Touchdown, Wisconsin! The PAT. A 9-play, 56-yard drive, and they get it in for 7. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Sends it sailing downfield. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field. He throws right. Oh, boy, almost intercepted.
How did he drop them? The defender did everything that he needs to do. He read the play perfectly. He stepped up, and what does he do? He drops the interception. Boy, the offense caught a break there.
He gets out to about the 25-yard line. So the Badgers are going to call their second timeout. Third and 10. Ball on the 25-yard line. Tackle there in space.
You know, having a playmaker at tight end makes those linebackers think twice before they make a move. That could be just enough time for the quarterback.
And it's caught, and he's brought down quickly. So they go to the air and pick up 6.
It's a decent pickup that time on a well-designed play.
So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. Stays in bounds to make a nice catch. Nice pickup as they connect on the pass play.
Well, they look to be in sync right now. They're both reading the defense properly, and the result is a nice game.
Brought down right around the 28-yard line. Receivers got the first down. Tackle at the 24. The pass is complete for 4 yards, and that'll be a first down.
They've done a great job on this drive with the underneath pass. The quarterback isn't forcing the ball, and you can see how effective he is.
Going for it all to the end zone.
It looked like the quarterback thought he had an open receiver there, but I don't think he saw the linebacker.
And this is the 9th play of the current drive. Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun, 5 wide receivers. And they're going to put 6 DBs on the field to counter that 5 receiver look. Quick strike, and he drops it. It's the 11th play of the drive. takes it out to maybe the 7-yard line. Fires quickly. Touchdown. So they go to the air, and they come away with 6, Kirk.
Man, Brad, I got to tell you, that's not an easy thing to do there. The defenses nowadays are so tough when you get inside the red zone.
And he converts the extra point. Bowling Green kicked this one off. He just drills this one. He's to the 20. He's taken down at the 34-yard line. Wisconsin's team, when you look at them, I think they got to be happy with how versatile they can be, because they do have a star that is not having a star-type game right now, and yet they got the lead here, and we're almost at halftime.
Yeah, I think they've really shown their versatility as an offense. To think that we would be sitting here close to this first half being over, and to see that their go-to wide receiver is not putting up these big numbers, and yet they still have the lead, just tells you a lot about their coaching, the in-game adjustments, and the way the rest of the teammates this receiver stepped up.
Wisconsin is up by 4. He's going to try and scramble. Decides to slide. Wisconsin's called their final timeout. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. One more play now before we hit halftime, so they'll most likely throw one towards the end zone here. He wants it all, going long. It's caught. He's all the way. Touchdown. The extra point. We played a half of football. Wisconsin leads 21-10.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Keith Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. There is nothing, and I mean nothing, that is more important than turnovers. Now, so far, neither defense has been able to force one in this game. But you never know when that opportunity is going to come up.
No, and people look at turnovers and they assume that it's luck a lot of times, but a lot of times it's preparation. It's being able to know that when certain teams line up, like South Carolina back in 2002 in a certain formation where it's Tucson Oakland stud, and they got 3 receivers to my side, and I know it's a rollout pass. As a defensive end, I widened my stance a little bit, came upfield, hit the quarterback as he was throwing it. Next thing you know, the ref signals his hands up in the air, and you get 6 points for it. So you can definitely be prepared, and that's how you force those turnovers.
That's it for us here in the studio. What are you going to do in the second half while the game's going on?
Yeah, I'm going to kick back and watch all these monitors.
We'll keep you up to date on everything going on around the country right now. Time for the second half with Brad and Kirk.
All right, Reese, David, thanks, guys. Just about set to start the third quarter. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Well, this is turning into a shootout here. Now, remember, the last time we saw this offense out in the field, they answered the bell and scored a touchdown. Can they do that now a second time?
The offense is on its way out on the field again, and they haven't had any problem finding the end zone in their past couple of drives. Tackle after a decent run up the gut. From their own 31-yard line. Second down. Gets it out to the tight end, and he can't hang on. Well, he tried to thread the needle with that pass.
Well, here the quarterback makes a poor decision throwing into coverage. Needs to look at his progression and find the second and third receiver.
24. From their own 44-yard line. First down. Makes it to the 47. The 43-yard line. First down. They make the stop at the 44-yard line.
That's a zoom yard on the play. That makes it second and 10.
Man left. Four down. Mike seven. Go 4. Go.
Made at the 32. First and 10. Ball on the 32. Gives it right side. Good outside run there. It's the ninth play of the drive. Around the 25-yard line. A yard, maybe two on the carry.
That makes it third and three.
And so it's another third down upcoming here.
Tight right. Four down. Seven to one. Red two. Red seven. Red seven. Motion.
The tight end's got it for a first down. And down he goes at the 13-yard line. This is the 11th play of this drive. And a quick throw. A huge play, and now they're in a great position to score.
This guy has that innate ability to get just enough distance from a defender to make a completion possible. You don't see it from every receiver, but this guy's got it.
It's first down. And they come to the line with a first and goal. Touchdown, Badgers. And he tacks on the extra point. 12th play, 75-yard drive, and they put up 7 points.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook try. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
So our score, 28-10. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. So the Badgers coaching staff's got to be elated over on the sideline about what they plan to do with this wide receiver and the plans coming to fruition.
Absolutely, and they continue to be able to find ways to give him the football. That's the thing that's been probably most impressive, not just his ability, but how they've moved him around and gotten the football to him in different ways. It makes it very tough on the defense. Smart, heady play by that defender. That was solid, fundamental pass defense.
From their own 25-yard line. Second down. They'll bring him down at the 35-yard line. Fires it out. He's taken down at the 46. Makes it to the 44.
I'm coming.
hands it to the back. And they got him for a loss. From the 45-yard line, it's second down. Makes the catch and look out, and he's tackled at the 40-yard line. Quick throw to the tight end. He's tackled in the open field. Hit and taken down. The lineman got a little ahead of the snap count. Here's the call.
False start. Offense.
You got to be careful to avoid these. Penalties are a great way to stall out a drive.
From the 30-yard line, second down. Looks to the back and can't connect.
Running back makes a solid effort, but there was just no chance for him to make a play on that throw.
Here's play number 10 on the drive. Zips it to the tight end. Brought down around the 18-yard line. He's under some heat. Moves up in the pocket and down he goes.
That'll make it second and long.
Here's the 12th play of the drive. Around the 13-yard line.
What impresses me so much is the guy's vision. He read the coverage perfectly to find his man for good yardage.
All right, we're just about set to start action here again in the fourth quarter. To his receiver, and that sets them up with a first and goal.
That's good for a game of 12 yards. That makes it first and goal.
Quick throw, tight end, touchdown. He was looking at the tight end the whole way there.
Yeah, the quarterback has to be careful of telegraphing the throw, but hey, it worked. They scored anyway.
Well, they're going to try for the two-point conversion. Unable to convert that two-point conversion on the ground. So a 14-play, 79-yard drive, but they just get after failing to convert for two.
Brad, I love these kind of drives. They're old school, grind it out and earn the yards and just rip the heart right out of that defense.
Wisconsin's a team on a mission right now, it appears. They have put up 20 points in a row. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. He might have a chance. Tackled after a decent pickup.
That'll make it second and
So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. Up the middle for a nice gain. The ball, and the defense is on it, and he's taken down around the 36-yard line. That's a big break for this defense.
You know, this offense just can't afford to be getting hit with the turnover bug. They need to hold on to the football.
Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive. Back's got it on the quick throw.
That's good for a gain of 2 yards. That makes it second and eight.
Looks middle, got his back. And they make the stop, the 27-yard line.
Number 11 on the tackle at the 27-yard line. That'll make it third and one.
On the catch, and he steps out. Pass right, running back's got it. Excellent open field tackle.
That's a gain of 6 on the play. That'll make it second and 4.
And he makes it out to about the 17-yard line. Less than 3 minutes in the game. Crosses out to the tailback on the screen. They bring him down in the backfield. The offense that takes the field on fourth down. He's going left. Quick strike to the receiver. Touchdown. He's thrown his third touchdown pass of the game.
He's been letting it fly today, and his receivers are making plays. That is a great touchdown.
He makes the PAT. Bowling Green, ready to kick this one off. He really got a hold of that kick. He's to the 20, and goes at the 25-yard line. So the Badgers having everything going their way right now. They have put up 20 straight points on the board. Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game. There he goes. He's to the 40. Gets out to around the 45. First down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 45. Just over 2 minutes in the game.
Yeah.
36-yard line.
Let's give this quarterback a lot of credit. He recognized the man coverage. And guys, I'm going to tell you something. He probably knew he was going to go to the post before the ball was even snapped. Well done.
Gains his way to the 23-yard line.
I think the defense put everything into that sequence of plays. And for the offense to come up with a first down really is demoralizing for the defense.
Gets out to about the 21. The running back gets two on the carry. It's second down, eight to go. Ball on the 21. Off the right side, doesn't get much. Good tackle. Defensive coordinator side of things, and why not? His defense just came up with one of the biggest stops of the game in a vital spot in this fourth quarter. Fourth down. They're going to try a long field goal here. Under a minute left in the game. He gets it up, and it's long enough, and he nails the long field goal.
That one looked like cake for this kid. Chalk up 3 points for the offense.
31-23, Wisconsin. And with time winding down, they probably won't let this return man feel the ball. He'll take it from the two. He got hit hard. And here comes the offense again. They'll try to make it two touchdowns and two possessions.
I think that right now just sitting back on their heels. They're allowing the offense to kind of dictate things to them. And the one thing is that any defensive player will tell you in the country, you have to be the one trying to dictate things to the offense. So change it up. Try something different. If it's not working, you can't continue to sit back on your heels.
So this one's in the books, and we saw a great one here today. 31-23, Wisconsin. Thanks for joining us for another game of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk and everyone here at EA Sports, Brad Nussler saying goodbye, and we'll see you next time.